So even if you already know about hot corners, you may want to stick around to the end of this video because I've got an interesting tip you may not know about. So what hot corners are basically, they allow you to trigger an action on your Mac if the cursor goes to one of the corners of the screen. You get to them by going to System Preferences, and you can either go into Desktop and Screensaver and the Screensaver portion, or to Mission Control, and there'll be a button for hot corners. And then you can see the four corners of the screen and choose an action for them. Now a lot of the actions at the top of this list have to do with Mission Control. Either launch Mission Control or show the application windows, that kind of thing. So if you're used to using Mission Control, this is just another way to do it. Then you can do some other things like bring up Notification Center, bring up Launchpad, start the screensaver or disable it if you leave the cursor there, put the display to sleep. Disabling screensaver is really useful. You can just put your cursor down in a corner of the screen and it won't go into screensaver mode. And put the display to sleep is what I use. I actually put that on the bottom right, put display to sleep. And then when I'm walking away from my Mac, all I have to do is drag my finger down my trackpad to the right. It puts the cursor down there and the computer goes to sleep without me having to do any kind of special key combination or choosing from a menu. But like, let's try Launchpad here. And I'm going to move the cursor to the bottom right corner of the screen. And you can say it brings up Launchpad. And then it stays there. Even it just launches it when I go to the bottom right hand corner of the screen. So I can still go and select something. If I go to the bottom right hand corner of the screen again, it actually takes it away. But let's say you have trouble with this because you accidentally move your cursor to a corner every once in a while and it activates it. It can be annoying. Well, you can add modifier keys to this. This is what a lot of people don't know about Mission Control. See, if I select the menu items here and I hold down on my keyboard the Command key, you can see how it modifies it. I can do Option, I can do Control, I can do Shift. I can do combinations like Command and Option. So now if I hold down Command and I select Launchpad, you can see it shows Launchpad but with the Command key symbol there. Now when I hit OK, if I move my cursor to the bottom right hand corner, nothing happens. But if I hold the Command key down and move to the bottom right hand corner, I get Launchpad. So this allows you to further customize how this works and may make it more useful for a lot of people.